I'm here to share this wonderful word of God with you, which is in the book of Saint Matthew, 11th chapter, verse 28. Jesus said, "Come to me, all who labor and are heavy laden, I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and lowly in heart, and I will give you rest for your soul. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light." Jesus said, "His yoke is easy and his burden is light." So many people are carrying heavy burdens. So many people are carrying heavy yokes. So many people are carrying unbearable yokes. But Jesus promised here that if you come to me, oh my God, if you come to me, I will give you rest for your soul. Because your soul needs rest. Your soul needs rest. The Bible says he came to seek and to save that which was lost. Nobody can save something that is already lost, but only God can do that. The Bible says we were lost, but now we are found. That is why I'm bringing this divine word of God. That is why I'm bringing this good news of God. So that you don't sit here and suffer. You don't sit here in this condition thinking that you cannot survive. Thinking that this is your final destination. Your life is not your final destination right now. What you're going through right now is not your final destination. Your current situation ain't your final destination, because God is still in control. God is still exists. God is still have grace for you. So I'm bringing this grace for you, so this grace can make your life better. And once your life becomes better, your life is going to be blessed. Your life is going to be balanced, because he's a blessed God. He's a blessed God with benefits. He promises. He promises life and life in abundance. We're sitting here today in an informal settlement, in Captain's Creek informal settlement. But we have a formal God. We have a God who is so formal that he came down to send his only begotten son because he loves you. He don't want you to die in these conditions. He don't want you to die in poverty. He don't want you to die living the way you do. He don't want you to live a life of sin. He don't want you to be inclined in sin, because he gave his life for you, man. He gave his life for you and I. The Bible say he was hanged on the tree. He said he became cursed for you and I because he was hanged on the tree. He became sin for you and I, so that you and I can be the righteousness of God. So you don't have to spend 1 second more in sin. You don't have to spend 1 second more